Hey everybody, and welcome to a new slash old Let's Play. This is Super Stardust HD. So yeah, something like, I don't know, 6-7 years ago, it's been a while, but I Let's Played this game before, and yeah, I did kind of a bad job, I guess you could say. Yeah, this is Super Stardust HD, and I didn't record it in HD. The video quality was terrible, the audio quality was terrible. My commentary was alright. Yeah, when I originally played this game, I only did easy mode. But this time, we're gonna go a step further. We're gonna go to normal mode. And as you can see, I've already played through, and I've unlocked all four planets here. So yeah, we're gonna go with the first planet. So yeah, arcade mode is the closest thing you can get to a regular single-player story mode. So that's what we're gonna be doing. And we're not gonna be doing too much else other than this. We're gonna be playing through the four planets, and we're just gonna try to have a good time, a good chaotic time. And yeah, this is in fact live commentary. In case you're new to the channel, I always do live commentary, like 99% of the time. Unless something happens to, like, you know, my commentary audio or something, like something goes wrong. Alright, we're gonna grab that. Boom. So, yeah, when you find these green asteroids, they always have, like, bonuses and stuff in them. And if you do a charge through it, you get multipliers. So if I do that, you can see I got, ooh, quite a bit of multipliers right there. So yeah, it's a good idea to do that from time to time, get some extra points. And points do matter in this game, because you can get extra lives. And you do have limited amount of lives before it kicks it back out, just kicks it right back out to that menu. So yeah, the game starts out pretty tame. It's not too chaotic at the moment. Although we are on normal instead of easy this time around. So yeah, it will be more chaotic than it's ever been. So yeah, just explaining a few things. We got multiple weapons. We got stuff like the ice splitter here and the rock crusher. And all of them have good uses for certain situations. I almost always like to stick with the gold melter right here, just because I can go pretty nuts with it. It's I don't know, it reminds me of a flamethrower. It's not quite a flamethrower, but you know, you can just spread it all over the place. You can just do like circles with the control stick and you'll take out almost everything. Whoa, that UFO almost just... almost just rammed right into me. Yeah, you gotta be careful of those. Try to keep your distance with the flying saucers, because they will take you out. Alright, so now we have a limited amount of enemies left before we move on to the next phase. And this first planet here, it's pretty darn easy. Second planet, a little more difficult. Third planet, pretty difficult. And then the fourth planet is actually not hard at all, and I don't know why. Kind of interesting. I did it in like one try, no game overs. I still had like a couple extra lives, I believe, and I was kind of confused. I was just like, huh, I just beat the game and the final level was easy, and the final boss is actually the easiest boss. Kind of strange, but you know, I'm not knocking it. It's fun regardless. So yeah, these weapon power-ups, if you just wait a second, they'll turn into a different weapon power-up. Don't wait too long though, otherwise it'll turn into a normal bonus where you just get points for it. And if something's just like points, like these little white ones, they will just disappear eventually, so make sure you try to grab those. Points are also good for, you know, the leaderboard and such, if you're interested in that kind of thing. I like leaderboards, I think they're cool. I don't usually go for like super high leaderboard stuff unless I really, really like the game. Like in Sin and Punishment 2, I was all over that leaderboard, dude. I was in, like, for a lot of the stages in Sin and Punishment 2, I was in the top 10. That's crazy. That's crazy, dude. And the game sold well over 100,000 copies, so, I mean, that's pretty good if you're better than about 100,000 other people. I was in the top, like, 1%, so... I don't know, I should stop bragging about that, but at the same time, that's one of, like... It's one of my life's few accomplishments, you know? I've accomplished very little in life, so that's, I don't know, when I get the chance to brag, I don't know, maybe I should just take it. I don't quite want the rock crusher. There we go, gold melter. Yeah, I like to level up gold melter first and foremost. Second most importantly is probably the ice splitter. Because the ice splitter here, it has the longest range. Oh, we got a supply ship that I just blew up. So yeah, the supply ships will have bombs. Let's just grab that. And another bomb. Yeah, the bombs are basically like screen clears. It clears almost everything around you. Take out that saucer. Get out here, you. And the cool thing about the gold melter is sometimes the flames will kind of like ricochet off stuff and then hit other stuff, which is pretty cool. It has kind of like a splatter effect, which is really good when you're fighting multiple saucers. Also, we have so many bombs. No FBI, I'm not doing anything nefarious here. I'm just talking about a video game. I wonder how many people are on the FBI watch list that are like, not even, like, shouldn't even be there, I guess you could say. Like, how many people? Probably a lot. You know, a lot of people are like concerned about like the whole privacy thing. They're just like, oh, the government's listening all the time. It's like, yeah, but it's more like the government computer is listening all the time. They don't have enough manpower to have like actual people listen to all your conversations. So like, I wouldn't worry like too much, but that's, I guess that's just me. Maybe because I'm smart enough to realize that there's no way they could have enough manpower for people to manually listen to everything. Like, that's just impossible. You would have to have an entire other country in on it, which would be ridiculous. So yeah. Yeah, I don't know, most people are just stupid. They're just like, oh, they're listening. It's like, now their computers are listening, really. Let's be realistic here. All right, couple more of the bombs. Yeah, so this game is like just really fun. I've played a lot of games like this. I like these kind of action-y games. Run around, do this kind of thing. Or in this case, you know, fly around. We're not running. The ship ain't got no legs, dude. Yeah, just grabbing some more points. Points are good, points are great. Take out them saucers. Yeah, I usually like to take care of as many asteroids as I can. Because when you start fighting a lot of enemies, you're gonna want the asteroids to be out of the way. Just saying. I mean, right now it's not that important. But, oh well. Also, funny thing, I was looking around earlier because I was like, if I play on hard mode, does anything, like, change other than, you know, it being harder? Like, are there extra bosses? Does the final boss have an extra stage? Answer, I don't know. I could not find anyone playing this game on hard mode. It was the weirdest thing. It was so strange. Because I was like, you know, like, I'm playing through on normal mode. And we should be able to see most of the content of this game. But I was like, you know, is there like an extra boss if I play on hard mode? Like, should I show that off for the Let's Play? And I guess not, because I couldn't find anyone on YouTube who actually played through on hard mode, which is crazy. Now, fortunately, we don't have to deal with anyone shooting at us just yet. But later on, there's gonna be like asteroids everywhere like this, and also people shooting at you. And it's just utter chaos. Unfortunately, one downside to the gold melter is sometimes— ooh, we got a shield. Shields are invaluable. They're just so important. But yeah, one downside to the gold melter is sometimes it can cover enemy bullets and you'll be like, what hit me? And it will be like, oh yeah, there was a thing there that you couldn't see. Also, I already lost my shield. Alright. Good job, me. Ooh, lots of points, man. Alright, we got a boss coming up. Oh, gold melter 100%. Huzzah. So yeah, if I get another gold melter power-up once we already hit 100%, we'll have like this like weapon overdrive thing going on, and it's pretty sweet. Alright, we got a boss. Okay, everything out of my way. Yeah, I'm gonna— ooh. Stuff is shooting at me. Yeah, I'm actually gonna just take care of these asteroids so I can properly dodge all these bullets here. Alright, ice splitter power up. Ooh. Yeah, so the gold melter cannot get through this guy's like arms or whatever while he's doing this little firing missiles thing. Also, these missiles do not give you any points, so don't be like, oh, I have to hit all the missiles. No, you don't get anything for it. These are just obstacles. Don't really get anything for it. Alright, can we get an ice splitter? No, gold melter? Okay. Alright, this will be good. Kill the boss nice and fast right there. Ooh! Ooh. That was my bad. Yeah, I tried to boost through that, but I did a bad job. I pressed the boost just a tad too late. Gotta be careful with that. It's better to hit the boost too early than too late, usually. Just saying. Ah, there's another asteroid. You know, it's crazy to think that so many games are inspired by asteroids. Like, probably this game is greatly inspired by asteroids. And asteroids came out, like, forever ago. Like, how old is that game? Like, 40 years old at this point? Now, if you use the ice splitter, you can actually kind of get past those arms a little bit. But when it's shooting missiles at you, maybe don't. Because it's kind of hard to hit all these missiles with the ice splitter, as you can see. Gold melter is good for this kind of stuff. Alright, this dude's mostly dead, so let's see if we can... Come on, dude. Get out of here. Come on. Aw, he's doing his thing again. Gonna... Ooh! Oh, I was like, oh, maybe I'll take him out like this. Come on. Ah, you know what? Fine. Fine, I'll wait for you. I'll be a patient boy. Took out one of my lives, dude. Can I do that? That didn't do a lot of damage. Alright, we got him. Careful, though. I think you can still die from those bullets. Alright, level complete. And with that, that's actually the first episode. So, thank you all for watching the first episode of Super Stardust HD. We got 3 more planets to go. So yeah, I bumped the microphone, oh well. I'll see you all next time.